Okay, we'll try this again. So we're going to take a introductory look at Run 8 Train Simulator 3. Just made the purchase, installed it, and I've gone through the process of and putting in the license code and getting that all set up. If you do do that, it's kind of tricky because you have to actually start a scenario to enter the license key. Once you do that, you can back out and then you will have access to the game. So we're going to start with the menu here, and this menu is great looking. It, I mean, definitely very clean, and I like the new blue outline on it. It's, I don't know, it looks really nice. And currently I have two regions. The region that is default with Run 8 Train Simulator is the UP BNSF Southwest, and I think that's going to give you three different routes and some rolling stock. And then what I've downloaded separate to this is the CSX A line. Now, I purchased this for version 2, and you, if just so you are aware, you can, if you have purchased stuff from previous versions, it does roll over. In fact, it will roll it over for you automatically, which is kind of nice. So let's go ahead and get started. Like I said, this is just kind of an introductory look into Run 8 because I'm looking at it for the first time as well. And I don't know a whole lot about it other than this is the first time that Run 8 has come out with an update. And I think it's over 2 years. In fact, I think in the last stream, I even mentioned that they had been quiet for such a long time. And that same day, I believe they actually came out with the new version. So I'm really excited, and I think we should go ahead and get started here. I'm not going to do the CSX A line. I'm going to stick with the Southwest for this. But I did have some issues previously when I was when I tried opening this up. So the tracks, signals, none of the rolling stock showed up. So I don't know if that's an issue that I'm going to have to deal with, but I know that the CSX works. So if it doesn't work for the Southwest, we'll go back to the A line. That being said, we'll choose the Needles sub. And then I'm just going to go ahead and pick one of these trains right here. I think it'll work. Hope it'll work. Okay. Awesome. All right. So I'm not going to do a whole lot of commenting on this because I really don't have that much to say right now. I just kind of want to play around. If I see something that really stands out, I'll say something. Otherwise, please feel free to comment. And we'll go ahead and get started. It looks like I picked a grain train. I didn't know that I picked a grain train, but I did. So that's what we're going to run. Looks like four engines on it. What comes available in this, it's going to be the Dash 9, the C-44 Dash 9, but it's only available in the Run 8 paint scheme. You're going to get the Gevo and UP, BNSF, and I think CSX. And then you're going to get the ST-70 ACE in CSX, I believe. So, man, I would be really excited to see the a BNSF Dash 9, though. Hopefully soon. All right, so I don't believe that this was something that was in the previous game, but just kind of the background noises, the birds chirping as you're walking, you can actually hear your footsteps. That's kind of cool. Kind of reminds me a little bit of Train Sim World, just a tad bit. So then we're gonna go ahead and, yeah, so it looks like they have I guess I'm wrong. They have an NS ST-70M-2. or ACE. This is an SD70 ACE, so this might be, this may be more fiction. No, maybe I'm wrong. That could be accurate. Anyway, a lot of the controls are the same as in the second version. So far, the graphics look really nice. We'll go ahead and get these engines started. You're going to turn the TV on? I don't know. It may. It's okay, though. I'm having other issues now anyway, so. For some reason it doesn't want to show. Game. See if that fixes it. Sitting here in the dark. Did it work? Here we go. That did it. Okay, well, I guess we'll try and see if that works. There we go. Now you're seeing what I'm seeing. I stand corrected. These are ES-44 DCs, not ACs. All right. So like I said, it's kind of the same as in the in version 2. You just click on the first engine and then you can just auto start all the engines from there. So I think all the engines are started now. We're gonna click on auto MU, auto EOT, and then auto CB and auto AB. And that should do it. Looks like we've got to take the handbrake off. That's released. We'll make this an empty grain train, just make it a little bit easier. Go ahead and hop in the cab. All right. And then I'm just going to go ahead and shut my big mouth, and we will just kind of enjoy the sounds of the game here, unless I see something that I feel stands out and should be commented on. I'll just kind of go ahead and play, and feel free to comment if you'd like. And here we go.